NASAMS, National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System, is an air defense system that works from the ground. It was created by Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace and RTX Corporation. NASAMS is capable of protecting areas against threats from the air at short and medium distances. This system is one of the greatest advances in anti-aircraft defense in recent decades. It is known for working very well in real combat situations and for being adaptable as needed. Since it began operating in the 1990s, NASAMS has become an important defense system for many countries around the world. Today, 13 countries use NASAMS. The United States has deployed the system to protect its capital, Washington, since 2005. NASAMS can take down various types of threats from the air. It can also work together with other NATO defense systems. For this reason, many countries choose NASAMS when they want to improve their air defense. The system defends against unmanned aerial vehicles, helicopters, cruise missiles, unmanned combat aerial vehicles, and fixed-wing aircraft, firing any of a wide range of existing missiles. This variety of missiles makes NASAMS very useful today as enemies attack using several types of aerial threats at the same time. NASAMS has improved a lot because of recent wars. In Ukraine, the system showed that it works very well for air defense. Colonel Per Steinar Troita, head of the Norwegian Air Force's support department for Ukraine, reported that the NASAMS systems used in Ukraine had a 94% hit rate. They shot down more than 900 cruise missiles and drones. More than 60% of these targets were cruise missiles, which are very difficult to shoot down.
NASAMS was created in the 1980s. At that time, Norway needed to improve its air defense. The Norwegian company, Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace, partnered with two American companies, Hughes Missile Systems and Hughes Aircraft Ground Systems Group. Together, they developed NASAMS for the Norwegian Air Force. As originally conceived, NASAMS would replace two Nike Hercules installations in the defense of air bases in southern Norway, where it would act in conjunction with F-16, providing a layered defense. This layered defense approach was revolutionary at the time, recognizing that different types of threats require different types of defensive responses. NOAA, Norwegian Adapted Hawk, was a Norwegian version of the American Hawk system, introduced in Norway in 1986 and withdrawn from operational service in 1995 to be replaced by NASAMS, which is partly a development of NOAA. This transition marked a significant evolution in Norwegian air defense technology. NASAMS was the first system to use a medium-range air-to-air missile launched from the ground. This was very important because it took a very good missile that was used on airplanes and adapted it for use on ground platforms. The missile had its own radar, which made it easier to control the firing system. The system continued to improve over the years. In 2007, NASAMS II was launched, an improved version that can use Link 16, a military communication system. NASAMS III is the newest version, which has been in use since 2022. It began operating in 2019 and has brought important new features. It can launch two new types of missiles, AIM-9X Sidewinder and AMRAAM-ER, and has launchers that can be transported by plane. NASAMS can be assembled in different ways to suit each country's needs. A normal NASAMS system has these main parts: a command center, called FDC, a Raytheon AN/MPQ-64F1, Sentinel 3D radar that finds targets in the air, a sensor that sees using light and heat, and several AMRAAM missile launchers. The Fire Distribution Center, FDC, is the system's control center. It acts as the brain that makes the decisions. The FDC can do several different tasks, depending on how it is configured: anti-aircraft defense, support for army operations, coastal protection, airspace observation, air traffic control, and other functions. Because it is so flexible, NASAMS can be used in many different combat situations. NASAMS 3 comes with an updated Fire Distribution Center Station, an ADX console that has ergonomic control surfaces and 3 30-inch flat-screen monitors. This modern interface facilitates efficient system operation even under high combat pressure. The radar system is crucial to the effectiveness of NASAMS. The AN/MPQ-64F1 Sentinel radar is used to detect, track, and engage targets at a distance of up to 120 kilometers, about 75 miles, depending on the type of target and operating conditions. The radar is capable of tracking multiple targets simultaneously, allowing NASAMS to defend against several incoming threats at once. The multiple engagement capability is one of the system's distinctive features. The missile system can engage 72 targets simultaneously in active and passive modes, providing a formidable defensive capability against saturated attacks. NASAMS' missile arsenal is one of its greatest strengths, offering the flexibility to engage different types of threats at different distances. The system's primary weapon is the advanced AIM-120 medium-range air-to-air missiles, which form the backbone of the system's offensive capability. The upgraded MK-2 launcher can fire 3 different types of missile: the AIM-9X Sidewinder Block 2 short-range, the AMRAE-AMER, and the AIM-120 AMRAE-AM. Having several types of missile available allows operators to choose the best missile for each type of threat. The creation of the AMRAE-AMER was a major improvement. The AMRAE-AMER is an improved missile that goes further. It uses a rocket engine from the evolved Sea Sparrow missile combined with an AMRAE-AM steering system. As a result, the missile reaches 50% further and climbs 70% higher, reaching a range of around 50 kilometers. This improved missile can take down targets that fly very fast and maneuver a lot. One launcher can fire up to 6 missiles quickly at one or several targets in the air. The launcher works in all directions, 360 degrees, and can be used both day and night in any kind of weather. This ability to work all the time is very important to protect against non-stop air attacks. NASAMS is used in many countries around the world, which shows that it works well and is reliable. In addition to the United States, 12 other countries use NASAMS: Norway, Finland, Spain, the Netherlands, Oman, Lithuania, Indonesia, Australia, Qatar, Hungary, Ukraine, and Chile. More countries plan to acquire the defense system soon. In the United States, NASAMS plays a vital role in protecting the national capital. NASAMS has been integrated into the air defense system of the U.S. National Capital Region since 2005. This deployment underlines the U.S. authorities' confidence in the system's ability to protect the most sensitive targets. Norway originally acquired the system in 1998. With NASAMS 2 and 3 introduced in 2006 and 2019, respectively. In 2023, more systems were ordered to replace the donation to Ukraine, with delivery scheduled for 2026/2027. In December 2024, 2 batteries and 2 simulators were ordered. Qatar was the first country to acquire the AMRAE-AMER, the Extended Range Surface-to-Air variant. It was used, among other things, to protect the 2022 FIFA World Cup, demonstrating the country's confidence in the system to protect a high-profile event with millions of spectators. The European expansion of NASAMS has been particularly noteworthy. Belgium will buy 10 NASAMS together with Luxembourg via the Netherlands. A system is planned for Luxembourg, reflecting regional defense cooperation. The conflict in Ukraine has provided a real combat test for NASAMS, and the results have been extraordinary. The Pentagon declared that NASAMS had a 100% success rate during Russian missile attacks on November 15, 2022. Ukrainian President Zelensky revealed that the system shot down 10 missiles from 10 targets. According to a statement by the Norwegian Armed Forces in February 2025, NASAMS systems in Ukraine have successfully shot down around 900 missiles and drones since November 2022, achieving an estimated interception rate of 94%. Almost 60% of these neutralized threats were cruise missiles, including KH-101, KH-555, Kaliber, Iskander-K, KH-59, and KH-69. These figures represent exceptional performance in intense combat conditions. The Ukrainian Air Force reported the destruction of 11 Russian cruise missiles in a single engagement using a NASAMS battery, highlighting a high level of operational performance. The Ukrainian unit managed to neutralize all the targets in a period of just 2 minutes, according to an official video released on April 27, 2025. Norway has been training Ukrainian NASAMS crews at its Riga and Ørland air bases, with graduates being deployed directly into combat. These units are responsible for defending critical infrastructure, including government buildings, power plants, hospitals, and airports, ensuring the continuity of essential services. International support for Ukraine through the supply of NASAMS systems has been substantial. As part of the 5th Ukraine Security Assistance Initiative package, the U.S. Army awarded a $1.2 billion not-to-exceed contract on November 30, 2022 to Raytheon Missiles and Defense for delivery of 6 National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System batteries, training and logistics support to Ukraine's military and security forces. The first 2 batteries have been delivered and deployed, and have successfully demonstrated the system's effectiveness against the threat. In March 2023, Norway announced the donation of 2 complete NASAMS firing units to Ukraine, in collaboration with the United States. This decision was part of the Nansen program, under which Norway allocates 15 billion Norwegian kroner annually from 2023 to 2027, with half of the 2023 funds earmarked for military assistance. These 2 NASAM systems are in addition to the 2 units supplied by the United States in the fall of 2022. NASAMS continues to be constantly improved to meet new threats. Raytheon is creating a new radar called GhostEye for NASAMS. This new radar will help the system find and track targets even better. NASAMS is designed to evolve as technology develops and can integrate or utilize future technology when available. This could be future active or passive radars and sensors, sensing and warning capabilities, and a wide range of effectors such as CRAM, CUS, and the Raytheon missile family, AIM-9X Sidewinder Block 2, AIM-120 AMRAE-M, and AMRAE-M-ER. The evolution is made possible by the open architecture in the FDC. Norway is greatly increasing its capabilities with NASAMS. The contract with the Norwegian Defence Materiel Agency is worth around 4.8 billion Norwegian kroner, including extra options. Delivery is scheduled to begin in 2027. The contract includes new missile launchers and new fire control centers for NASAMS. They will replace the equipment that was donated to Ukraine. The government is buying long-range air defense to protect Norway against short-range ballistic missiles. In addition, the quantity of the existing NASAMS air defense system will be doubled, and it will be upgraded to better protect against drones and missiles. Air defense systems donated to Ukraine will be replaced. Both the Air Force and the Army will receive more systems, and the current air defense systems will be upgraded. The system meets all NATO requirements for interoperability. In partnership with Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace, NASAMS is built on a modular, distributed, open hardware and software architecture. The system is positioned to embrace new technologies, capabilities, and resources to provide unparalleled air defense. The modular nature of NASAMS allows it to adapt to the specific needs of each nation. NASAMS is by nature a highly mobile system designed with a focus on operational flexibility for the protection of air bases, seaports, populated areas, other high-value assets, and army forces. NASAMS has demonstrated interoperability with higher echelon units and longer-range systems such as Patriot. The modular design enables mission-oriented task force organization of NASAMS, allowing operators to maximize the effect of components and adapt the system to the task. NASAMS is one of the most successful air defense systems in existence. It works very well because it uses tried and tested technology, can be adapted to different needs, fires various types of missiles, and has proven that it really works in combat. That's why many countries choose NASAMS to protect their airspace against modern threats. As the system continues to be improved and more countries are using it, NASAMS should remain one of the best air defense systems for many years to come.